Oh, I know you're working up an appetite for all that Easter ham if you're celebrating this weekend with your family, but we've got one of the newest restaurants in town in our studios. We've got Nate Goodner, a chef at Pork Belly Grub Shack. Emil Fromoli is the owner. You guys are already making the studio smell amazing. Let's start with the burger because that's cooking right now. It's hot, and I don't want you to burn it. It looks too good. Nate, what are you doing with it?
I am making our hot mess.
Hot mess, that's what it's called?
It's our hot mess with our garlic aioli, sautéed onions, and cheddar and jack cheese.
Ooh, and what kind of bread is that? It looks tasty.
That is sourdough bread.
Okay.
And it also comes with an egg on top.
Oh, okay, you can't leave the egg off of it.
Can't leave the egg, that's the best part.
Is that why it's called hot mess? Who named this? Was this you?
No, it was actually me. Okay. I'll give the credit for that one.
You're like, no. But if somebody walks into the Pork Belly Grub Shack, which is already an interesting name, they would say, I want the hot mess, please.
Correct, yes.
With fries?
Yep, that's the favorite.
Okay. And then, Emil, you've got something else going on over here. What do you have?
These are Asian street tacos, and this is our house-cured fried pork belly.
Ooh.
Little lemon aioli, sriracha, house-made teriyaki, some pickled carrot and daikon, and a little bit of
yeah, a little banh mi flavor
exactly.
Going on with pork belly. Why did you guys name it Pork Belly Grub Shack?
It's just because we love pork belly.
You just love it. This
love
is a family
belly.
Favorite.
Yes.
Okay. Because a lot of people favorites. Don't eat pork belly. It's not necessarily healthy.
It's
California cuisine, no.
Well, the whole restaurant is based around pork belly. We do fish. We do tons of different things, but pork belly is just kind of what we focused on it first.
So. And you have the cute little red and white checker tablecloth.
Yes.
So was the deal, because you guys have only been open 5 months, was the deal to create kind of like a Southern comfort, hometown kind of joint?
Exactly.
All right. We've got some actual videos of inside the restaurant. Nate, how do you run your kitchen? It's not a hot mess, but if you were to put it on the menu, if you were to write it on the chalkboard, what would you say about your kitchen and the staff there? That's
Ooh,
a good
that's a
question.
Hard one. Yeah, it is. I'm not sure about that one. Hot mess is actually the best to describe it.
Really?
Really, yeah. We get pretty wild back there.
But restaurants are hard work, aren't they?
It is, yeah. But I enjoy it.
You're excited about it.
Yeah.
Are you excited about this new venture?
Right.
What's your favorite thing to order? If you would say, Adrian, you're coming to my restaurants first time for your lunch, what would you say is the best thing
Probably
on the menu?
The Steak Shack. The steak sandwich.
Steak Shack. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to try the funky fried chicken, too, because I saw that on the menu earlier.
My favorite.
Okay.
My favorite.
And where are you guys located? Why don't we tell people where to find you when they go out to lunch?
It's 40.
Is that your phone? Are you waking up?
Yeah,
that's okay, Nate. You got busted. A lot of times we forget to turn off our cell phones on live TV. So let's talk about the address really quickly.
So it's 4261 Troxel, just right there behind the arena.
Behind the arena?
Yeah.
Have you had any
Kings
come by yet?
I believe.
No, Isaiah?
Unfortunately, no.
DeMarcus, we're calling you out.
Yeah.
You got to go stop by the Pork Belly Grub Shack. Come on, it's got a great name. Check it out, and we'll have more information for you at KCRA.com/morningnews. Thanks, guys.